So, I've been procrastinating on making this video for a while because I know that 2v2 Hellgates is actually a very broad topic to talk about. And for the longest time, I just didn't know where to start, I guess. But I do get asked a lot of questions while I'm streaming about 2v2 Hellgates, so I know that I needed to make this video. And after sitting down and thinking about it for a while, I think I managed to come up with a way to talk about it pretty systematically. And I hope this video will help you understand 2v2 Hellgates and help you find a place to start when it comes to building for it. Welcome back to Pewpew Academy. Today we're gonna talk about 2v2 Hellgates. Just like in the solo PvP video, we're not gonna talk too much about any specific build. Instead, I'll tell you the key concepts on how to build for 2v2 Hellgates, and I'll give you a few examples of how these concepts are applied in popular 2v2 Hellgate builds. I think by now most people already know what 2v2 Hellgates are, and some may have already dabbled in it, but since this is a video guide series made for new players, we'll just briefly go over what exactly are Hellgates. Hellgates are a form of team deathmatch arena minigame in Albion Online. You enter them by finding these demons in the open world, and when you kill these demons, they open a portal that leads you into the Hellgate arena. There's a 2v2 version and a 5v5 version. The bat-looking demon on the left will lead you to 2v2 Hellgates, and the big angry-looking ones on the right will lead you into 5v5 Hellgates. The idea of 2v2 Hellgates and 5v5 Hellgates are the same. You enter the gate, kill a bunch of demon bosses, and get a lot of loot at the end. But the catch is that you won't be alone in the Hellgate. There will be another team that entered the gate with you, and you will have to fight the other team for the loot at the end. Although the idea is the same for 2v2 and 5v5 Hellgates, the build style and approach for them are actually quite different. In today's episode, we'll only talk about 2v2s. 2v2 Hellgates are actually quite interesting form of PvP arena despite how simple it is. The objective of 2v2 Hellgates is basically team deathmatch. You kill the other team and get the loot at the end. But there are so many different ways to build for it. There's no one super dominant meta build, and you just never know what you get matched up against. And that is also part of the reason why I've been procrastinating on making this video, because I know it's going to be very hard to cover all these different builds and different ideas in one video, but I'm going to try. So let's talk about these ideas behind how to build for 2v2 Hellgates. Just like in the solo PvP video, where we'll talk about the core concepts for 2v2s, and I'll talk about some popular choices, but in the end you'll be making your own build, so keep in mind that the weapon and gear choices that I mentioned here are popular choices, but they're not the only choices. The point of showing you these popular choices is not to limit your options, it's to give you a place to start. And also, if you get yourselves familiar with these equipment pieces, you'll know what other people are running, and knowing your enemies will help you win against them. There are a lot of 2v2 Hellgate builds out there, but there are basically only three different categories for these builds. And these are one-shot builds, brawling builds, and oddball builds. The one-shot builds are probably the easiest builds to pick up, and they are exactly what they sound like. You pick a target, blow them up, and turn around and 2v1 the other guy. That's how a one-shot build works in 2v2 Hellgates. Now, there are different ways to go about making a one-shot build in 2v2 Hellgates. But the best ones will always include some ways to escape and a way for a reset on your cooldowns, because in a 2v2 there are a lot of things that can go wrong. Maybe your target gets a defensive skill off just in time, or maybe his partner interrupts one of your skills, but something could happen and prevent you from actually getting an instant one shot. So when your cheese fails, you need to be able to get away and wait for a reset. Some popular equipment to consider for this are, in the weapon slot, crossbows, especially regular crossbows, light crossbows, and bowcasters. Dagger pairs, death givers, claws, pikes. These are weapons that can do a lot of upfront burst damage, and bloodletters are often used to finish off the targets that got bursted. Battenbows and blazing staves are also capable of doing a lot of damage in their AoEs, but they require the target to stand still inside their AoEs, and to make sure that they do so, group keepers, tomb hammers, and quarter staffs are used to CC the target and keep them inside these AoEs. These CC weapons can also be high burst weapons when you run them together with a demon cape and a stalker jacket, because you can hold people still in the AoEs created by your demon cape and stalker jacket and do a lot of damage to them. In the helmet slot, demon helmets are often used to make sure that the target being bursted or the teammate is silenced and cannot do anything to stop your burst. Stalker hoods are also popular for the damage buff and armor piercing effect on low health targets, especially if you run it together with something like a bloodletter, just for finishing people off. In the chest slot, druid robes and stalker jackets are the most popular options for giving you more damage, and cleric robe and cultist robes are often used on the bow or blazing staff players because they tend to get focused, and everlasting spirit or levitate can be pretty useful for helping you survive the focus. Scholar robes are also used sometimes, especially by weapons like regular crossbows, because of the casting time reduction that it gives you. Knight armor is picked very often on the CC tanks, so if you're playing something like a Groove Keeper, for example, your job is just to hold people still inside your teammates' AoEs, so you don't actually need to deal a whole lot of damage yourself. So you can run the plate armor for the increased CC duration, and after you drop your burst, if it fails to kill, you can use the wind wall to help you get away for a reset. So you can try again after your cooldowns come back. In the boot slot, I think Scholar Sandals are still usable for Blazing and Battle Bow players. For the CC-based weapons, like your quarterstaffs and your pikes, you will want to run a Hunter Shoe for the increased CC duration. And Hellion Shoes are also a very good option for the high damage weapons like daggers and crossbows. In the cape slot, if you are running any kind of CC weapon like claws or pikes or quarterstaffs, a demon cape will do a lot of damage for you. If you're running a heavy hitting type of weapon like a dagger pair or a light crossbow, then you'll want to go with a Thetford cape instead. Remember that these are just some of the most popular weapons that people use. They're by no means the only ways to make a one-shot build. As long as you can create enough burst damage and then get away afterwards for a reset, there are many different ways to achieve this. Brawling builds are builds that have either a healer and a DPS, or two DPS players that have a lot of defensive skills. They might not always have the kind of damage to one-shot someone, but they have enough defensives to keep them going until their damage sinks in. So weapons to achieve this for doing damage, common weapon choices are broadswords, carving swords, light crossbows, boltcasters, black hands, regular bows, curse staffs, and great curse staffs. For healing, the two best choices now are druidic staffs and life touch staffs. Redemption staff, Great Holy Staff, and Basic Holy Staff are all used sometimes as well. The Great and the Basic Holy Staffs are used as cheaper options to the Life Touch, but I would recommend that you don't use the Basic Holy because in Hellgates you'll get matched pretty often against one-shot builds, and a lot of these one-shot builds may use a Bloodletter. So the Bloodletter actually counters the basic holy staff, because if your teammate gets to low HP, then the bloodletter will just execute him, so you'll never get the healing bonus off on your E. And the redemption staff is very strong as well, as long as the two of you don't get separated. As long as you can stay together, the little bouncy orb will keep bouncing between the two of you and heal you for a lot of damage. For your gear choices, the strongest chest piece to wear for basically all melee weapons in a brawling build, and for the healer, is going to be the Fiend Robe. But they can be pricey, so mage robes, cleric robes are viable cheaper options as well, and they're also good for ranged DPS players to use. The reason Fiend Robes are good for melee weapons is for two reasons. First, it's a very strong defensive skills that allows you to CC people near you. And you can use this to save both yourself and your teammate. And since you're using a melee weapon, you'll be in point blank range of your target all the time, so it'll be really easy for you to make full use of it. For ranged DPS though, the Mage Robe and Cleric Robe are easier to use. And Stalker Jackets are okay too for some weapons, but they're not the most popular option because they have a damage falloff. And in brawler builds, you want a high consistent damage. So usually, cloth robes are picked for DPS in brawler builds. For the helmet, Demon Helmet is a very common pick, especially for ranged DPS. Cultist Cowls and Stalker Hoods are very strong offensive options as well. Hunter Hoods are a great choice too, especially if you're playing a double DPS brawling comp. The damage reflection on it, combined with Guardian Boost, can help you counter a lot of one-shot builds. Cleric Cowls are also becoming more popular because of the fact you can use it while you're getting CC'd. This allows you to dodge damage from a lot of the one-shot builds. Hellion Hoods are used sometimes by auto-attack based builds, particularly by the regular bow, because you can still auto-attack people while you're stealthed in the smoke bomb. Scholar Cowls is often used for healers to manage their energy, especially for holy healers, because they can be pretty mana hungry, and a limper's cape by itself might not be enough. For the shoe slot, Guardian shoes were mentioned earlier, and cultist sandals are good too for both the healing reduction and armor piercing. It's a very strong offensive pick on the boot slot, and Hellion shoes as well for the bonus damage. In the cape slot, Darkfur capes are probably the best choice for damage, as they give you the most consistent damage of all the capes, and they're also pretty cheap. And Limper's capes are good too, especially for healer DPS comps, because both the healer and DPS are gonna have mana management issues in a drawn out fight. So if you get matched up against another healer DPS comp, the Limper's cape can help you out. Morgana capes and Keeper capes can work pretty well for some weapons too, especially for the regular bow. Oddball builds are ones that don't fall into either of the first two categories, and these can further be divided into three more categories. These are kiting builds, solo builds, and rats. The most common form of kiting build is double warbow. Double warbow is probably the second most hated build in 2v2 Hellgates because it's extremely frustrating to be chasing after them while they're throwing their magic arrows at you from max range. They are especially hard for double DPS to deal with because without sustain, they will eventually wear you down and poke you to death. But they tend to have a harder time against a one healer, one DPS build because double warbow can't really one-shot you and their damage falls off pretty heavily after their initial burst. So healers usually have no problem keeping you alive against them, especially if you could dodge some of the skill shots that they fire at you. Warbow is not the only good weapon for kiting. Fire staffs are sometimes used as well because the firewall ability is one of the best for keeping chasers away, especially since in 2v2 Hellgates, you have a lot of these little choke points where a firewall will completely cut off the path. Sometimes you'll also see solo builds in Hellgates. Most solo players in Hellgates are no reason for concern. They might be there for just fame farming, or they might be testing their luck to see if they get matched up against another solo player. But there are some solo builds that you really need to watch out for. These are one-shot pike builds and Deathgiver builds. Deathgivers can easily win a 1v2, especially against a double DPS comp. There are also some builds that rely on mobs in the Hellgates to kill you. In Hellgates, all the mobs, except for the bosses, create an explosion when they die. So if you lure the other players into chasing you close to the mobs, and you kill the mobs, and then use a displacement skill like a knockback or a pull, you can bring them into the explosion, which could one-shot them. Lastly, there are some people that won't try to fight you at all. They will instead try to steal loot from the chest that spawns at the end. These are the people that we call rats. A rat build is usually something that has extremely high mobility, like bloodletter or a one-handed spear. I said earlier that warbows are probably the second most hated weapons in Hellgates. That is because rats are the most hated. Now, ratting is actually a pretty complicated matter, and to play against a rat also takes some preparation. So I've made another video on ratting and anti-ratting, and I'll provide a link to that video in the description below if you're interested. While you're deciding on how you're gonna build for 2v2 Hellgates, you might also want to think about bringing a few backup options besides your main build. You can switch to these backup options when you get matched up against a specific build that you might have problems with. For example, if you're gonna play a brawling build, I highly recommend that you bring a knight helmet and a spear just to keep them in inventory until you get matched up against a rat. And when you do get matched up against a rat, you can switch to these items to counter them. Now, like I said earlier, 2v2 Hellgates is a pretty broad topic, and I do want to keep this video short, so I went over a few things kind of briefly. So if there's anything you want me to elaborate on, please jump into my Twitch channel. I'll provide a link down below, and you can ask me while I'm live. Also, keep in mind that PvP in Albion Online is something that changes a lot. And with the Queen's patch right on the horizon, we'll probably see some changes to the meta in 2v2 Hellgates when the patch releases. So, to keep up with any future updates, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and if anything major happens, we'll be sure to talk about it in a future episode.